What's up? Chocolate money thing right here.
What's up, guys? It's your girl Jamira, and I'm back. And as you see, my nails looking trash can emoji. So it's time for a touch up. So I'll grab some nail polish remover, and this is the cheap kind. That's $1, cause you know your girl is cheap. I go for the cheap stuff. And yes, it does have acetone in it. It doesn't really bother me. So yeah, I'm just taking off all the polish off my nails, making sure I have every speck off. After I've taken off all my nail polish, I go ahead and go and wash my nails. And I'm just using regular soap and a nail scrubber brush. And so I just take some soap and I wash my hands first, because you know, you can't expect to have clean nails without clean hands. So I wash my hands, then I go ahead and scrub my nails using soap and the brush, and making sure I go and scrub each nail individually and all together, getting both on top and underneath the nail. Then I rinse off all the soap and grab a towel and pat dry my nails. And here. These are what my nails are looking like after I've thoroughly cleansed my nail, as you can see. And so what I like to do is quickly start on my cuticles right after I clean my hand, and I use the California Mango cuticle softener, and I put one little small dollop on each cuticle and I rub it in and I push my cuticles back, and you'll see the rest. And I'll leave it on for 1 minute. After the 1 minute, I come back and take my metal cuticle pusher, and some people are afraid of this and they prefer to use the wooden stick or the orange stick or the plastic one, but me, I don't care. I'm very safe and careful. After I push back my cuticles, I take some nail polish remover, and this is just one that's in a pump bottle, and what I'm doing is wiping away all that extra cuticle softener, because I don't want to leave that on. As you know, that breaks down skin slowly, and that's not safe to keep on. Then I take my favorite, this ultimate manicure system. It's a battery-powered drill. Yes, a battery-powered drill. You always see the electric ones in the nail salon. Well, baby, I got me a battery-powered one that does the same job for cheaper and safer. I take the cuticle bit, which is the metal, the skinny metal one, and I use that and go around my cuticles, and this is just to further get rid of that dead skin. So after I use the metal cuticle bit, I like to use the smaller, skinnier nail shaper bit, and I like to go over my cuticles one more time just for neatness and safety purposes. So I like to take the thicker shaper buffer bit, whatever you call it. I use this to buff my nails. And it gets the job done just like a manual handheld buffer. Then I grab a soft grit emery board and go over my nails one more time, lightly buffing it. Next, I take a harder grit emery board and shape my nails. I decided to change the shape of my nails based on the fact that my nails were totally different shapes. And plus, my nail had broke right before I recorded this video. The shape I chose was a kind of coffin shape because my nails were oval, so it was pretty easy to make into a coffin, you know, shape similar to that. I'm really careful while doing this. I used to go by the rule of, and I mostly still go by it, is only swipe your nail with the nail file once at one time instead of doing it back and forth. I like to do it in one direction. However, I realize it's kind of time taking. I still will suggest it. Just for me, I don't really care which way I do it. It still is fine. My nail still turns out fine. Now to one of my favorite parts, and this is moisturizing my cuticles. So I'm taking the Burt's Bees lemon cuticle balm, cuticle cream, whatever you want to call it, and I'm just putting this on my cuticles and my nail bed. People like to say this is their holy grail, this Burt's Bees, saying it's the nail crack of all crack or whatever, but really it's just the same as some regular oil. At the end of the day, it worked all the same. After that, I take this Nail Lift Nails cuticle oil and I put this underneath my nails because you want to get on both sides of your nails, not just on top but also underneath. And I like this one because it uses different oils. These oils like avocado oil and what else? I done forgot, but stuff like that. Not just beeswax like the cream. And I of course take some lotion. You know, I love me some lotion. So hand cream does the job just well. This is just to moisturize your hands. Now I'm back at it again with the nail polish remover, and this is just to get all the excess oil, because if you have too much oil on your nails when you're trying to polish them, then it will be hard for the nail polish to last long. It's more prone to chipping. So I'm taking this Sally Hansen Double Duty and using this as my base coat. And I'm probably going to forget to mention it later, and I didn't show it in the video, but I also use it for the top coat. So I'm just putting it on my nails. I only use about one coat of this, like you'll see. I'm being honest, I didn't polish my nails exactly immediately after I put on this base coat because I kept it on for a day because I was busy. But yeah, I'm just getting my brush ready to clean up any excess nail polish around my nails, my cuticles. And the polish I'm using is Sinful Colors, as you'll see right here. And it's in the color Starfish, and I love this. So I'm showing you a close-up of me polishing my nails. All I'm doing is starting at the base of my nail, so near the cuticle, and kind of curving it forward to the end of my nails, then doing two or three more strokes down just to fill it in, make it look nice. And I start off with one coat on all my nails. Then I go back again a couple minutes later after it's had time to dry a little and add a second coat. And all I do in total is two coats. And for me, it's okay if it looks crappy the first coat because I'm gonna add a coat right on top of it. You won't even be able to notice. Yes, girl, I slayed these nails if you think so. You should like and subscribe, and yeah, peace out.